just for yours. I'm just for yours.
Yeah, come on, just pray out in the spirit right now. I feel like we're in a real time of surrender.
Yeah.
We're in a real time of surrender. Just pray in the spirit. Just sing out in the spirit. Oh, yes, God. Yes, God. Come on, front to back, side to side. You're at home right now. Begin to just pray in the spirit. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Right here, God. Sing in the spirit. Sing a new song. God's breaking in. He's breaking forth. You know, one thing we battle here in California is wildfires. And I saw a fire when I used to live in Salt Lake City, Utah. We had a mountain behind our house. And one day some people were out, National Guard was out shooting and some rounds went off and it sparked a fire on a real dry day. And I'm sitting there and this flame all of a sudden came up over top of the mountain and the entire valley was watching this mountain get consumed in fire. As the mountain, as the fire was, you could see it was wild. I was looking at the flames just going like this, just like a huge hand just waving on top of this mountain. It was huge, just burning the trees. And then it came over the mountain and just continued to burn. You know what's amazing about fire is it just has no respect. It just came over the mountain. It didn't say, oh, wait, guys, this tree is cool. Let's leave that one here and go around it. The fire of God is the same way. The Bible says in Hebrews 13, our God is a consuming fire. It's the kindness of God that he's a consuming fire. It's the mercy of God that he's a consuming fire. It's the love of God that he's a consuming fire. Because anything in our lives that isn't of him needs to be burned out. And when the fire of God comes, it's like the finger of God coming, and he puts his finger on things and he just burns it out of our lives. And then he sets us on fire like a flaming mountain for a whole entire city to see. And when they look at us, they don't see the stuff in our lives. His it got dealt with at the cross. It got covered. The shame got covered in the blood. And now the world sees us. They see a victorious person covered in Christ. Something for the world to look at, because we're a trophy of his grace and a trophy of his mercy. The fire of God. I pray that we are entering into a time where the fire of God would consume every part of our lives, that the fire of God would consume our marriage, it consume our attitude, it consume everything inside of us, it would consume our children as they sleep at night, it would consume our churches, it would consume every part of us, it consume you sitting at home, it would consume. Our God is a consuming fire, and if you'll give your life to him, he will. Lennon Ravenhill prophesied years ago, he said, the fire of God won't die in you. He'll continue to burn forever. He won't die in you. Come on. Our ability to burn in God isn't dependent on our ability to be passionate. Passion has a fuse. The fire of God is connected to the unending river of his love that never changes. It's continually flowing. Come on. Put your hand on the person next to you and just say, let the fire of God, just say fire. Fire. Fire, release fire. Release fire. There's a baptism of fire in this place tonight. A baptism of the Holy Ghost is gonna come. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire of God. Burn up, burn up, burn up. Fire of God. Fire of God. Fire of God. Woo! Jesus. Burn up shame. Burn up pornography. Burn up sexual immorality. Burn up lust. Burn up pride. Burn up the wrong image of you. God, let gold be revealed in Jesus' name. Jesus. Yes, God. More Jesus. If you've not received your prayer language yet, just say, God, I receive it. I want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. Speak in tongues. Just begin it. Speak in tongues by faith. Fire. Fire. You get to pray the perfect prayer, a prayer connected directly to God, a prayer directly connected to heaven, where your tongue submits your entire being to Jesus, because your tongue directs your life, and your tongue gets submitted to the Holy Spirit. Fire, 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 fire of God, burn. Fire of God, consume. Fire of God, consume.
Oh,
Your hands tonight. We're waiting because I can feel it. There's something happening. I can see God all over you. Just receive whatever He's doing in your life right now, God. We receive what you're doing in us, God. We receive what you're doing in it. We might not have words, but we receive. Come on, just sing out in the Spirit. We'll be right back.
to you forevermore. Oh,
so good. I feel so many things right now. God wants to just pour out revival. I know that's like a common word, but it's really true. He wants to revive the earth. He wants to revive the earth through Christ. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things pass away. Behold, all things become new. Amen. Man, when the fire of God hits your life, he removes the things that obstruct love, and joy is the result. We have a glorious joy. Come on, somebody. We got joy. We got joy. We got joy. We got joy in this place. Come on. I feel like we're supposed to have a dance party. I feel like y'all are supposed to just act like teenagers, get young again. Come on. Let's blow the roof off this place. Come on. We got joy. We got victory. Jesus is alive.
It's not something we despise, it's something that we take up with joy to follow him.